Hello students, welcome to the online session of chemistry. In the previous session we have studied about empirical formula and molecular formula. So today I am going to discuss with you the new concept, that is stoichiometry. Stoichiometry. So stoichion means element. So stoichion means element. Metry means measurement. So what is stoichiometry? It is a branch of chemistry which deals with the calculation of masses of reactants and products involved in a balanced chemical equation. So the stoichiometry is a branch of chemistry which deals with the calculation of masses, of reactants and products involved in a balanced chemical equation. So now let us study about what is meant by a balanced chemical equation. So consider the composition of methane. The molecular formula of methane is CH4 plus O2 gives rise to CO2 plus H2O. CH4 plus O2 gives rise to CO2 plus H2O. Methane, it's a gas. Oxygen, it's a gas. Then carbon dioxide is also gas. Then this water in vapors form. Therefore, I will write as this is also in gaseous state. So these G represents the physical states of the reactants and products. Methane and oxygen, these two are reactants. Carbon dioxide and water, these two are products. Now it's not a balanced chemical equation. Now this equation to be balanced, so starting from methane, so in methane there is one carbon atom and four hydrogen atoms. So on LHS the term which contains hydrogen is water. So here there are four hydrogen atoms, but here only two hydrogen atoms. So therefore I will put here two in order to balance the hydrogen atoms. So that is here on LHS four hydrogen atoms are present. On LHS four hydrogens are present. Now go for oxygen atoms. On RHS, how many oxygen atoms are present? So 2 plus 2. In a molecule of oxygen, there are 2 oxygen atoms. So therefore, total number of oxygen atoms on RHS is equal to 4. 2 plus 2, that is equal to 4. But on LHS, one molecule of oxygen is present. A molecule of oxygen contains 2 oxygen atoms. So therefore, I will write here 2. Now, the oxygens are equal to 4. 2 times 4. Now, this equation is known as a balanced chemical equation. So now, how many carbon atoms are present? On RHS, one carbon. On LHS, there is one carbon atom. So therefore, this equation is known as a balanced chemical equation. This chemical equation is known as balanced chemical equation. So how many moles of methane are involved in this reaction? Means the coefficient of methane is 1. Then similarly, what's the coefficient of oxygen? Means how many moles of oxygen are involved? So that is 2 moles. Then how many moles of carbon dioxide are formed? 1 mole. How many moles of water vapors are formed? That is 2 moles. So these numbers are known as stoichiometric coefficients. So these numbers are known as the coefficient of the reactants as well as products are known as stoichiometric coefficients. Then this balanced equation gives some information, that is how much mass of methane reacts with how much mass of oxygen, then gives how much mass of carbon dioxide and water, then how many moles are involved in this reaction. So then how many molecules are involved in this reaction, or how much volume, because all the reactants and products are involved are in gaseous state. So therefore this gas occupies volume. How much volume of methane is involved in this reaction? How much volume of carbon dioxide is formed? So that is also explained with the help of this balanced chemical equation. So first, in terms of moles. So from this equation, it's clear that 1 mole of methane reacts with 2 moles of oxygen, then gives 1 mole of carbon dioxide and 2 moles of water. So 1 mole of methane reacts with 2 moles of oxygen, gives 1 mole of carbon dioxide and 2 moles of water vapors. Then in terms of mass, so 1 mole of a substance equal to how much mass of the substance? That is equal to its gram molecular mass. So what is the molar mass? So or gram molecular mass. So that is, this molecular mass is equal to sum of the atomic masses of the different elements present in a molecule. So therefore the molecular mass of methane, the number of carbon atoms, that is 1 into its atomic mass 12, plus the number of hydrogen atoms 4 into its atomic mass. 12 plus 4, this is equal to 16. Then if it is expressed in grams, then it is known as gram molecular mass. That is 16 grams of methane reacts with how much mass of oxygen? So there are 2 oxygen atoms in a molecule of oxygen, therefore the molecular mass of oxygen, that is 32. 16 into 2, that is equal to 32. But 2 moles, 2 molecules of oxygen are present, therefore 2 into 32 grams. Then how much mass of carbon dioxide is formed? So the molecular mass of carbon dioxide, that is CO2. So 1 atom of carbon into its atomic mass 12, plus the molecular mass of oxygen is 32. So 12 plus 32. So this is equal to 44. The molecular mass of carbon dioxide is 44. If it is expressed in grams, then it is known as gram molecular mass. So therefore 44 grams of carbon dioxide is formed. Then 2 into the molecular mass of water, that is equal to 18. So 18 grams of water are formed. That is, when 16 grams of methane reacts with 2 into 32, so that is equal to 64 grams of oxygen, then it forms 44 grams of carbon dioxide and 36 grams of water. 36 grams of water. Then in terms of volume, that is, the 1 mole of any gas at STP occupies 22.4 liters. 1 mole of any gas at STP occupies 22.4 liters. That volume is also known as molar volume or gram molar volume. Here 1 mole of methane. So this occupies how much volume at STP? 22.4 liters. Here 2 moles into 1 mole of oxygen occupies 22.4 liters. 1 mole of oxygen, that is gaseous or gaseous carbon dioxide, this also occupies 24.4 liters. Then 2 into, so 1 mole of gas or vapors at STP occupies 22.4 liters. So therefore, so 2 into 22.4 liters, 2 into 22.4 liters, that is, this is equal to 44.8 liters. This is also equal to 44.8 liters. That means, so 1 mole of methane occupies 22.4 liters. 22.4 liters of methane reacts with 44.8 liters of oxygen to give 22.4 liters of carbon dioxide and 44.8 liters of water. Then in terms of molecules, 1 molecule of methane reacts with 2 molecules of oxygen to give 1 molecule of carbon dioxide and 2 molecules of water. So now, based on this concept, we will solve some problem. ಕೆಲವು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ಸ್ ಅನ್ನ ಈ ಕಾನ್ಸೆಪ್ಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ನಾವೀಗ ಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಮಾಡೋಣ. ಸೊ ಅಂದರೆ ಮಾಸ್ ಟು ಮಾಸ್, ಮಾಸ್ ಟು molecules are mass to molecules, mass to mole are molecules. So ee relations, ee interconversions anna naavu maadabodu. Mass kottidre moles alli calculate maadodu, athava mass kottidre molecules alli calculate maadodu. So ee ondu concept mele kelavu problems anna naaviga solve ಮಾಡೋಣ. The first problem is, so in your study material, the page number 6, the first problem, in the study material, the page number is 8. The first problem, calculate the amount of water produced by the combustion of 50 grams of propane. Calculate the amount of water. Calculate the amount of water produced produced by the combustion of by the combustion of 50 grams of propane. 50 grams of propane. So in this problem, there is a relationship between amount of water to the mass of propane. So in order to solve this problem, first we have to construct the balanced chemical equation. That is, what's the reaction? Combustion of propane. Then what is the molecular formula of propane? Propane contains how many carbon atoms? So which contains 3 carbon atoms, then it is an alkane. So therefore C3H8 is the molecular formula of propane. Combustion means what? Burning with oxygen. Therefore plus O2. Then on combustion, propane gives carbon dioxide and water. C3H8 plus O2 gives rise to CO2 plus H2O. This is not a balanced equation. First, balance the equation. Start from propane. How many carbon atoms are present in propane? There are 3 carbon atoms. This is the only term which contains carbon. So therefore, I will write here 3. So now carbon atoms are balanced. How many hydrogens are present in propane? So 8 hydrogens. So therefore, the water is the only term which contains hydrogen. So in order to make it 8, so I will write here 4. So then this becomes 4 twos are 8. Here also 8 hydrogen atoms. Now we are left with oxygen atoms. How many oxygen atoms are present on RHS? 3 twos are 6 plus in the second term 4 oxygen atoms. So this is equal to 10. So on RHS there are 10 oxygen atoms. So therefore I will write here 5. Then 5 twos are 10. Now oxygen atoms are also balanced. Now this is a balanced chemical equation. So now using this equation, we can solve this problem. So yen solve madbeku navu iga hagadre, amount of water produced by the combustion of 50 grams of propane. 50 grams propane anna burn madidare hagadre, a 50 grams of propane eshtu water anna produce madutte ಕೊಡತ್ತೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವಿವಾಗ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಹೇಗೆ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು? ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಈಗ ನಮಗೆ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೋಪೇನ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ದು ಸಹ ನಾವೇನನ್ನು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು? ಮಾಸ್. ದೇರ್ ಫೋರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡರ್ಡ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್. ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಕ್ವೇಷನ್ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಮಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೋಪೇನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇನ್ವಾಲ್ಡ್? ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 1 mole ಆಫ್ propane on combustion gives 3 moles of carbon dioxide and 4 moles of water. The 1 mole of propane is equal to how much mass? That is equal to its gram molecular mass. Therefore, calculate the molecular mass of propane. So, how many carbon atoms are present? There are 3 carbon atoms. Then what is atomic mass of carbon? 12. Plus how many hydrogen atoms are present? So there are 8 hydrogen atoms and its atomic mass is equal to 1. So, therefore, 2 3s are 36, 12 3s are 36 plus 8. So, this is equal to 44. The molecular mass of or the molar mass of propane is 44. If it is expressed in terms of grams, then it is known as gram molecular mass. Next, we want how much of water. So, therefore, I will write here how much of water is formed by the combustion of 44 grams of propane. So, 4 into the molecular mass of water, that is equal to water. So, this contains 2 hydrogen atoms multiplied by its atomic mass plus 1 into 16. 2 plus 16, this is equal to 18. The molecular mass of water is 18. If it is expressed in grams, then it is known as gram molecular mass. So, that means 44 grams of propane, 44 grams of propane on combustion gives 4 into 18 grams of water. 4 into 18 grams of water. But in this problem, only 50 grams of propane is burnt with oxygen. Then how much mass of water is produced? So, on cross multiplication, this gives 50 into 4 into 18 divided by 44 this is equal to 81.8181 grams of water. So, this is the answer, 81.8181 grams of water is formed. This is the answer. So, this is the method to solve the problem. Next, the second problem, calculate the mass of water formed when 100 grams of hydrogen reacts with oxygen. Calculate the mass of water formed when 100 grams of hydrogen reacts with oxygen so calculate the mass of water formed when 100 grams of hydrogen reacts with oxygen. Now, we have to write the equation for the formation of water. Water is formed by the reaction between hydrogen and oxygen. H2 plus O2 gives rise to H2O. H2 plus O2 gives rise to H2O. Now balance this equation. So here there are two oxygen. So therefore I will write here 2H2O. Then how many hydrogens are present on LHS? 2 2s are 4. So therefore to make it 4, I will write here 2. 2H2 plus O2 gives rise to 2H2O. 2H2O. So 2 2s are 4. 2 2s are 4. O2, this is 2O. From this equation, so again, in this problem, we have to calculate the mass of water when 100 grams of hydrogen. The mass of hydrogen. Hydrogen is also given in terms of mass. Then the mass of water is also calculated in terms of mass. So therefore, how many grams of hydrogens are involved in this reaction? That is 2 into the molecular mass of hydrogen is 2. So 2 grams is the gram molecular mass of hydrogen. Then how much of water is formed? 2 moles of water. Then what is the molecular mass of water? So that is equal to 18 grams. So therefore 2 into 18 grams of water is formed. So how much of hydrogen is involved in this reaction? 100 grams. So therefore 2 into 2, 4. 4 grams of hydrogen on reaction gives 4, 2 into 2, 4 grams. 4 grams of hydrogen on reaction with oxygen gives 36 grams of water. This is from the equation. So, but in the given problem, how much of hydrogen is reacted? 100 grams of hydrogen. So therefore, it produces or gives how much mass of water? So on cross multiplication, so then this gives 100 grams into 36 grams divided by 4 grams. That is 4 ones are 4 nines are, that is equal to 900 grams of water is formed by the reaction of 100 grams of hydrogen. Then third problem in the study material, that is calculate the mass of dioxygen. Calculate the mass of dioxygen evolved on complete decomposition of 5 grams of potassium chloride. Dioxygen means oxygen. So therefore the given compound, that is calculate the mass of dioxygen evolved on complete decomposition of 5 grams of potassium chloride. Potassium chloride. The molecular formula of potassium chloride is KClO3. KClO3. Potassium chlorate KClO3 on decomposition gives potassium chloride and oxygen. Potassium chlorate on decomposition gives potassium chloride and oxygen. So, balance the equation. KClO3, there are 3 oxygen atoms. So, therefore, this is 3O2. So, then this becomes 3 to the 6. So, therefore, I will write here 2. 2KClO3. Then there are 2 Ks and 2 Cls. So, therefore, I will write here 2KCl. So, now it is a well balanced chemical equation. So, first calculate what is the molecular mass of, because calculate the mass of dioxygen evolved on complete decomposition of 5 grams of potassium chlorate. So, both are given in terms of masses. So, therefore, first calculate the molecular mass of potassium chlorate. So, atomic mass of potassium is equal to 39. The atomic mass of potassium is equal to 39. So, therefore, molecular mass is equal to, so this is equal to, how many potassium atoms are present? Only one atom. So, therefore, 1 into 39 plus 1 into, how many chlorine atoms are present? 1. So, 1 into atomic mass of chlorine is equal to 35.5 into. So, what is the atomic mass of oxygen? 16. 16 threes are 48. Then the sum is equal to 39 plus 35.5 plus 48. That is 48. So, this is equal to 122.5. The molecular mass of potassium chlorate is equal to 122.5. So, here in this equation, 2 moles of potassium chlorate is involved. So, therefore, 2 into the molecular mass of potassium chlorate is 122.5 grams. So, 2 into 122.5 grams of potassium chlorate is 3 into the molecular mass of oxygen is 32. So, 3 moles of oxygen in terms of mass, this is equal to 3 into 32 grams. 3 into 32 grams. So, therefore, 2 into 122.5 grams of potassium chlorate on decomposition gives 3 into 32 grams of oxygen. 3 into 32 grams of oxygen. But in this problem, just they gave 5 grams of potassium chlorate. Then 5 grams of potassium chlorate on decomposition produces how much mass of oxygen? So, this is on cross multiplication. So, gives 5 grams into 3 into 32 grams. This is divided by 5 grams. That is 5 into 3 into 32 grams divided by 2 into 122.5 grams. So, then this is equal to 1.9591 grams of oxygen. This is the answer. So, this 5 grams of potassium chlorate on decomposition gives 1.9591 grams of oxygen. The next problem in the study material is calculate the mass of the aluminium oxide formed when 12.5 grams of dioxygen reacts completely with aluminium. The given atomic mass of aluminium is 27. Calculate the mass of aluminium oxide formed when 12.5 grams of dioxygen reacts completely with aluminium. Calculate the mass of the aluminium oxide formed when 12.5 grams of dioxygen reacts completely with aluminium. So this aluminium reacts with dioxygen means oxygen. So this aluminium reacts with oxygen, then it forms aluminium oxide. Its formula is Al2O3. So then we have to balance this equation. So that is, how many aluminiums are present here? 2. But here is only 1 aluminium atom. Then here 2 oxygen atoms, but here is 3. So therefore, I will put here 2. That is 3 oxygen atoms. This is odd number. So therefore, I will put here 2. Now, how many aluminiums are present? 4. So therefore, I will write here 4 aluminium. 2, 3 is a 6. How many oxygens are present on RHS? That is 6 oxygen atoms. So therefore, I will write here 3 oxygen atoms. That is 3 tos a 6. So this is the well balanced chemical equation. So in this problem, we have to calculate the mass of aluminium oxide formed when 12.5 grams of dioxygen reacts completely with aluminium. So therefore, how much of oxygen is involved in this reaction? 3 moles. Then in terms of mass, so that is 32 grams. The molecular mass of oxygen is 32. 3 into 32 grams of oxygen that reacts with aluminium to give aluminium oxide. That is how many moles? 2 moles. Then calculate the molecular mass of Al2O3. How many aluminium atoms are present? 2. Then its atomic mass is 27 plus 3 into 16. So this is 54 plus 48. So this is equal to 102. So that is equal to 102. 102. So this is 2 moles of aluminium oxide is formed. So, therefore, 2 into 102 grams of aluminium. So, that is 3 into 32 grams of oxygen on complete reaction with aluminium gives 2 moles of aluminium oxide, that is in terms of mass, that is equal to 2 into 102 grams of aluminium. But how much of oxygen is involved? 12.5. So, therefore, 3 into 32 grams of oxygen on reaction with aluminium gives 2 into 102 grams of aluminium oxide, Al2O3. Then 12.5 grams of oxygen gives how much mass of aluminium oxide? So, on cross multiplication, this gives 12.5 grams into 2 into 102 grams divided by 3 into 32. 3 into 32 grams. 3 into 32 grams. So, this is equal to 26.5625 grams of Al2O3. This is the answer. 12.5 into 2 into 102 divided by 3 into 32. So, gram, this gram cancels, then finally you will get the answer in terms of grams, that is 26.5625 grams of alumina is obtained by the reaction between 12.5 grams of oxygen. Then, what is meant by limiting reagent? Limiting reagent. So, limiting reagent is the reagent. Limiting reagent is the reagent which is present in smaller amount, which is present in smaller amount than mentioned in the balanced chemical equation. It is the reagent which is present in smaller amount than mentioned in the balanced chemical equation. So, this limiting reagent decides the product formation in a chemical reaction. So, in order to explain this, I will consider a simple example, that is the formation of ammonia from nitrogen and hydrogen. N2 plus H2 gives rise to NH3. N2 plus H2 gives rise to NH3. So, here there are two hydrogens and here 3. So, therefore, in order to balance the hydrogen atoms, so I will write here 2, then nitrogen is balanced. At the same time, on RHS, how many hydrogens are present? 6 hydrogens, therefore, I will write here 3H2. So, this equation tells us 1 mole of nitrogen needs 3 moles of hydrogen to give 2 moles of ammonia. 1 mole of nitrogen needs 3 moles of hydrogen for the complete reaction to form 2 moles of ammonia. If this reaction is carried out by 1 mole of nitrogen, if the same reaction, for the complete reaction of 1 mole of nitrogen, how much of hydrogen is required? 3 moles of hydrogen is required. But this same reaction is carried out by 1 mole of nitrogen and 1 mole of hydrogen. Then 1 mole of hydrogen. So in this reaction, so this amount of nitrogen is more than, so therefore the amount of hydrogen, that means for the complete reaction of nitrogen, nitrogen now tagondiro astu nitrogen no complete agi react aagbeku ant helidre adakke eshtu moles of hydrogen beku 3 moles of hydrogen beku but ee reaction alli avaru tagondirodu eshtu ant helidre 1 mole of hydrogen hagagi complete nitrogen no enagodilla illi react agodilla so therefore this hydrogen is known as the limiting reagent. It is the reagent which is present in smaller amount, which is present in smaller amount than the mentioned in the balanced chemical equation. This balanced chemical equation tells for the complete reaction of 1 mole of nitrogen, 3 moles of hydrogen are required. But this reaction is carried out by taking 1 mole of nitrogen and 1 mole of hydrogen. So in this reaction, the amount of nitrogen will not react completely. Some of the nitrogen is left behind in the reaction vessel. Then the amount of hydrogen is present in smaller amount. So therefore, this is known as the limiting reagent. The reagent which is present in excess, that is known as excess reagent, that is nitrogen. Therefore, so in a balanced chemical equation, in this balanced chemical equation, 1 mole of nitrogen needs for its complete reaction 3 moles of hydrogen. But in this example, in this reaction, 1 mole of nitrogen is mixed with 1 mole of hydrogen. So therefore, this much of nitrogen will not completely convert it into product. Some of the nitrogen is left behind in the reaction vessel. So therefore, the hydrogen is present in smaller amount. This is known as limiting reagent. Then the reagent which is present in excess, that is known as excess reagent. That is known as the excess reagent.